Page 7 in your bulletin is our Alleluia verse as we say, praise the Lord, that we get to hear about Jesus and we get to hear from Jesus. So let's say it together, the Alleluia verse. Alleluia, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight, all flesh shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia. It's Holy Gospel according to St. Luke from the 3rd chapter. And glory to you, O Lord. We would expect nothing less from Luke, the great historian who gives us so much about the birth of Jesus, Caesar Augustus, Quirinius, all that great detail, would now tell us about the forerunner of Jesus, John the Baptizer, and again, ground him in history, in the history books. This is what used to scare the heck out of you in history class, because you're afraid there's going to be a pop quiz and you had to name all these people, okay? I'm not giving you a pop quiz, but I want you to hear this John and when he comes and how God had everything set in line in his plan. So Luke chapter 3, it's on page 1091. We read this. In the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, Pontius Pilate being governor of Judea and Herod being tetrarch of Galilee and his brother Philip, tetrarch of the region of Iturea and Trachonitis and Licinius, tetrarch of Abilene, during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, the son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. And he went into all the region around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be made low. And the crooked shall become straight, and the rough places shall become level ways. And all flesh will see the salvation of God. And he said, therefore, to the crowds that came out to be baptized by him, you brood of vipers, snakes, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Instead, bear fruits in keeping with repentance. And do not say to yourselves, we have Abraham as our father. For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children for Abraham. Even now the axe is laid at the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. And the crowds ask him, what then shall we do? If they were Lutheran, they would have said, what does this mean? But same kind of thing, okay? And he answered them, whoever has two tunics is to share with him who has none, and whoever has food is to do likewise. Tax collectors also came to him to be baptized and said to him, teacher, what shall we do? And he said to them, collect no more than you are authorized to do. Soldiers also asked him, and what shall we do? And he said to them, do not extort money from anyone by threats or by false accusations, and be content with your wages. And this from the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.